Hey guys, and welcome back. Today I wanted to share with you my favorite terracotta lipstick shades from the drugstore. I've been requested to do a video on terracotta lipsticks a few times now, so I figured I'd better do this video for you guys. Plus, terracotta shades are some of my favorite shades to wear on my lips, possibly even my most favorite shade to wear on my lips. I love warm lipsticks and warm color tones. I think they work with my skin tone really well, and most of the time I'm wearing some kind of warm nude, rosy nude, or like a terracotta-esque shade on my lips. I have done a couple videos on these types of shades before, so I will link my warm nude, rosy nude lipstick video down below, as well as a video I did on terracotta makeup products, so I will list that both of those videos down in the description bar. But I did want to also point out that it's really, really hard to find terracotta shades at the drugstore, especially for lipsticks. Just a little bit tough to find. So a lot of the shades I'm going to share with you are kind of variations of terracotta, more brown shades, some more brick tones, even like some more nude shades as well. I'm going to be swatching all of these on the back of my hand as well as on my lips so you guys can see them both ways. That's everything I wanted to say. Thank you guys so much for watching and enjoy. I'm gonna start off with the most nude, I think, and I'll go from nude to deepest so you guys can see the full spectrum. First one I wanna share with you is a Maybelline Into Matte lipstick in the shade Raw Chocolate. The Into Matte lipsticks for Maybelline are basically just a matte lipstick. They're very comfortable. They feel nice on your lips and they last a really long time on my lips as well. The shade Raw Chocolate is a really pretty deeper nude. It has hints of brown in it. It has hints of clay in it. I think this would flatter a variety of skin tones. I think if you're fair, you could pull it off. If you had a deeper skin tone, you could pull this off. But this is definitely one of my favorite shades to wear on my lips. Not just because the formula is great, but just the color is so flattering and I really, really like it. This is the CoverGirl Kitty Cat Matte Lipstick in the shade Couture Tricot Griffs. Mine is really, really dirty because this is what I carry around in my like travel makeup bags. This is a little bit more reddish than the Raw Chocolate shade I just showed you. It has a little bit more of a red undertone. I think it looks really, really pretty on your lips. The formula of these is really, really good. I think it's a highly underrated lipstick at the drugstore. They feel comfortable, they don't dry out my lips, and they last a really long time on me as well. Plus, they have a little bit of a sheen to them, which I actually like. It just makes my lips look a little bit more healthy. I think this is one of my favorite lipsticks of all time. So easy to pull off, and it's a little bit more exciting than a nude. This is a great lipstick option if you are interested. Because I'm doing these in like order of color, got a mix between lipsticks and liquid lipsticks. This next one is from NYX. It's their lingerie liquid lipstick in the shade Seduction. Again, this is a color you guys have seen me wear in a lot of videos. It's such a pretty tone. It has a lot of warmth to it, like all of these shades do, but it also has hints of brown and hints of nude. I find the lingeries from NYX really, really comfortable. They don't dry out my lips. They don't last a super long time because they're so comfortable. I actually don't mind that they don't last. They don't swatch the best. You'll notice in the swatch that it's a little bit streaky, but they don't look streaky on your lips. You just gotta make sure that you don't pack on too much because then it can get a little bit crumbly. Such a pretty color and definitely one of my favorite everyday shades. This next one is a lipstick that whenever I'm wearing it in a video, there's always at least one person who asks what shade am I wearing, and it is the L'Oreal liquid lipstick in the shade Cowboy. This has definitely become my favorite liquid lipstick of all time, not just because of the color, which I love, obviously, but because of the formula. The L'Oreal liquid lipsticks last forever on my lips, and especially this shade. I have a bunch of other L'Oreal shades as well, but Cowboy lasts the longest on my lips. They just don't budge at all. They don't transfer. I would totally recommend you pick up one shade, and I would obviously recommend Cowboy because it is my favorite. If you have a similar skin tone to me, I think this would look great on you. I think it flatters warm complexions and kind of more olive toned skin. It is a nude, but it is a deeper nude. It's definitely got those terracotta vibes. It's like my favorite liquid lipstick, and maybe shade, like favorite just in general lipstick shade of all time. I wear it so often. I probably wear it the most out of all of these shades that I'm going to share with you today. So another liquid lipstick that I'm wearing incredibly often in my videos is the Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink Lipstick in the shade Fighter. This is probably the truest terracotta lipstick that I'll show you today. It's definitely the most orange of the shades. I think it's probably the most accurate to the actual shade of terracotta. It is a little bit trickier to pull off, I find, than the other shades I'll show you because it's got more of that orange brown tone to it, which isn't, I don't know, it can sometimes look a little bit off, but I still do really like it and I wear it very, very often. The Maybelline liquid lipsticks last a really, really long time on my lips. They don't feel drying and they have really good pigmentation. So if you want something that is probably the most terracotta shade that you will find at the drugstore, definitely check out Fighter by Maybelline. Be a good formula, and if you're into those types of shades, this is totally one I would check out. So the next one I want to share with you is another NYX lip lingerie. This one is in the shade Exotic. This one definitely has more hints of red than the other shades I've showed you. It's actually quite similar to the Couture Tricot Griffs from CoverGirl. It's got more of that reddish undertone, that mauve-y undertone. To me, this one feels very much like those roofs you see in Croatia, like the red roofs. I've already talked about the formula. I really like it, and this is definitely a wearable shade. I wanted to include it as another option for you guys. And then really, really similar to that is the Milani Amour Matte Lip Cream in the shade Loved. This one just has a little bit more pigmentation to it. It's a little bit deeper, I don't know, more rich almost in color. This isn't my favorite liquid lipstick formula, but I wanted to include it because of the color. I find that this lipstick crumbles on me a little bit. It's a beautiful, beautiful shade, and I wear it in makeup tutorials a lot, but I can only wear it for like a couple hours because it just crumbles on me. It feels dry. It does dry down completely matte. It gives you a really velvety finish. It's just not the most comfortable liquid lipstick. I really only wear it because of the shade. Just another option for you guys. I think it's a really, really pretty color, and I just wish the formula was better because then I think this would be one of my favorite. This one is the Wet n Wild Megalast Liquid Catsuit Liquid Lipstick in the shade Give Me Mocha. This has definitely more hints of brown to it than the other shades, but I still think it fits in this category because it does kind of have those terracotta undertones. I don't like the formula of the Wet n Wild liquid lipsticks. I find that they're so streaky when you swatch and when you wear them on your lips. I find that they're just too streaky. I don't think the pigmentation is great on these and they don't last on my lips. I don't know if anyone else has the same experience with the Wet n Wild ones, but they just don't last on me at all. I do love this color so much, so I kind of make do because it's such a great color. We are almost done. I have not actually done any lip swatches yet, so I'm dreading it. I haven't done lip swatches in a really long time. Plus, my lips are so dry right now. They're all like peeling and gross. I moisturize them and I put on a lip balm, but they're still really gross, so I'm not looking forward to swatching these. This next one is the Revlon Matte Balm in the shade Fierce. Nobody talks about these matte balms anymore. Like, do you even remember these? Like, these crayon balms? I think the formula is good. They have a nice minty cooling sensation. They have a matte finish. They don't last the longest time, but they're also super easy to apply because they're in this like pencil form, this fat crayon form. And I love the shade Fierce. It is definitely deeper than the other shades I've shown you. If you are maybe interested in trying browns, this would be a good shade to start off with because it's comfortable, it's easy to apply, it's not as daring as like a liquid lipstick. So I thought I would include it in case you were looking for a deeper, more brown terracotta shade. This next one is the lipstick that I'm wearing on my lips right now. It is one of my favorites. I love this shade so much. This is the e.l.f. Velvet Matte Lipstick in the shade Brick. I think this is like the most flattering red terracotta shade I've ever tried. It's not so red that it's hard to wear. Like, I find this very, very wearable. I can wear it to work. I don't feel uncomfortable. And if you are looking for something that's more red but still wearable and still has those like brown undertones, I think you would really like this. It's named completely accurately. It does look like a brick. It reminds me of a brick. The formula is so good. It feels so nice on your lips. It really does feel like velvet. It lasts super long on me. It's actually a very, very long-lasting lipstick. This is just like a brick in a tube. I love it. And last up is kind of like a bonus because it's not actually, you actually can't find it at a drugstore. This is the H&M Beauty Cream Lipstick in the shade Ferrum Brick. I wanted to include it because it is terracotta. It is affordable. It's just not accessible at drugstores. But look at this shade. I love, 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 love this shade. This one has orange in it, it has red in it, it has brown in it. It's a nice cream formula, but I don't find it strays out of my lip line. I don't find it bleeds. I think it lasts very, very long on my lips, and it's such a rich, deep, pigmented color. And the packaging is beautiful. I really want to pick up more H&M Beauty lipsticks. No one talks about them anymore. They were like all the rage for a bit. Definitely pick up Ferrum Brick if you are looking for something that is. So that sums up this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I haven't done a lip video in so long. I'm really out of practice doing these, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know if you have any questions below about any of these shades. Also, if you have any other terracotta shades from the drugstore that I haven't swatched for you here, let me know because I love this color. But yeah, that sums up this video. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe if you would like to see more, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!